Hey, dude. You know you just hit 1,000 subscribers, right?
Yeah, dude, it's awesome.
Well, now you gotta make that Mr. Beast video.
God damn it.
So, hey everybody. We did it. We made it to 1,000 subscribers. I'm overwhelmingly honored by the amount of support. The fact that I can say that there are, you know, 1,000 people out there who have come across my channel or my videos in some capacity and have chosen to click the subscribe button, that's really cool. It means I'm having an impact, which is ultimately the reason why I created this channel in the first place, which was to educate, to mentor, to inspire people who are going through this very tumultuous period in their life, applying to medical school, or really trying to get wherever it is they're trying to go. Because I understand that not all of you out there that subscribe to my channel are here because of the videos I make regarding medical school. Some of you are here for other reasons.
Where's my cookie, Mr. Beast?
Hey, that's awesome. I'm super happy to have you here as well. But I don't want to forget the identity of the channel, which is to ultimately inspire people, help people, educate. That's why I love doing this. And today is sort of a day of celebration. It's a day to commemorate this accomplishment. And I have a few things I want to talk about, and it's going to be a pretty chill, like laid-back video, so feel free to go grab a cup of coffee or a snack, something enjoyable, so you can come back, sit down, relax, and just listen to me chat away. So first of all, I just wanted to celebrate and honestly just say thank you so much. It feels otherworldly. Can't imagine the kind of impact that it's had on my life, and I know, like, in the grand scheme of, like, YouTube and videos and channels that get, like, hundreds of thousands or even millions of subscribers, it seems like a very small and minute sort of thing. For me, it's been built up in my head as something that I've been trying to achieve now for over a year. While I haven't been super successful all the time, I've had ups and downs on this channel, I haven't always been super consistent, I haven't always made the best content, I feel like I've learned a lot as a content creator and as a videographer, a photographer, a marketer, and I've just been loving the creative aspect of this medium. And I've always loved this medium. I've always loved making videos. Overwhelmingly honored by those of you who chose to click the subscribe button, those of you who continue to watch my videos and comment and interact with me. It's just like, it feels great to have you here with me, and I feel like I'm having a positive impact, which is always great, and it's what I want, and it's why I originally created this channel. So again, from the bottom of my heart, I'm gonna say it again and again throughout this video, but just like, thank you. Thank you for being here with me. Thank you for being interested in this journey of mine and taking part in it and being a part of it, because I do see really all of you as being integral parts of that journey, and I couldn't have done it without you. And yeah, I'm just very honored. So again, from the bottom of my heart, so I actually started making videos long before I ever started sort of a career path, if you will, here on YouTube. Back in the day, I used to love skateboarding. I was a huge skateboarder, and my brothers and I, we would always make these skating montages. And it was a great way of like creatively expressing ourselves while enjoying something together and enjoying what we loved, which was skating. We would always make just like such fun videos, and it kind of developed my love and appreciation for this type of media. Long, long before that even, my grandfather used to take me out to the beach when I was like 7 or 8 years old. And he's an artist, and he makes these beautiful, beautiful watercolor paintings. But he also loved to do photography. So we'd go out to the beaches in Portland, Maine, where he would paint while I would take photos with his camera. And I fell in love with it. And so I really did nurture this medium from a very young age, and it was something I actually had abandoned for a pretty long time. I've mentioned this in my past videos, but when I graduated high school, I also moved to Brooklyn, New York, where I was trying to act, and I was doing film and independent work and stuff like that. And I sort of rekindled that passion of mine, and it was great. I loved it. I had such a great time making film, writing scripts for videos, and it scratched that creative itch of mine. But I was also still really insecure. You know, I was 18, I was living alone in Brooklyn, New York City, I had no friends, and I just felt so insecure about creating content, and it was something that I sort of abandoned. And so it's very poetic for me, even now, sort of being 26 years old, going to med school, I'm on such a different career path, and yet I've still now been able to find a way to exercise this creative part of my life in a medium that I love and simultaneously help and inspire people like you. And so I'm super excited to be a part of YouTube. I'm so excited to be a part of all of your lives, and I'm excited for you to be a part of mine. And that's sort of like the origin story of how I got involved in making videos. And why I started making videos in the first place for people like you was because I wanted to use what I had learned and what I had nurtured from such a young age to try and reach people from all across the world. I wanted to tell my story to try and maybe inspire people who felt similarly lost and are trying to find purpose in their lives or trying to succeed at something that's super, super difficult. And that's why I created this YouTube channel in the first place, was I wanted to help people. I wanted to inspire people that were on journeys like mine. And that's the most rewarding part of this, that I get to educate and inspire people while simultaneously exercising this passion for making videos and things like that. And it feels really great, you know, reaching 1,000 subscribers. Again, I mentioned it before, but I feel legitimized in a weird way. Like I was just sort of pretending before, just like I felt like I was pretending before I'd gotten into med school to help all of you on this journey, because I didn't know if I would succeed, but I did. And I felt legitimized then. And sort of in the same way, I feel legitimized now. I feel like, okay, now this is a new beginning for me, and I'm excited to see where this channel goes. I like to think of myself as a pretty ambitious person. You know, I dedicate my life to achieving goals with higher and higher expectations. But I have found that the side effect of that ambition is that the psychological reinforcer that motivates me to continue making these videos, it's not contingent upon actually achieving goals, but it's actually contingent on me setting goals, having goals that to strive for. And upon completing those goals, you're sort of overwhelmed with like a sad loss, like a disappointment, or like something that you have, that's been by your side for so long, is leaving. It's not taken from you, but it's leaving. And it's kind of a lonely and alienating feeling, and it sounds so weird and doesn't sound right. It sounds like you should be happy when you achieve these milestones and these goals. But again and again, it's been proven to me sort of anecdotally that when I set out to achieve something and I finally achieve it, I'm overcome with like a bittersweet feeling, which is like, yes, I achieved this goal, but this goal has really been by my side now for so long and has motivated me to keep moving forward. Now having accomplished it, it's sort of behind me, and it feels like, man, I need another goal. And I guess that's how I feel about this milestone. And it's not that I'm sad or I'm upset that I made it here. I'm so happy and I'm so proud of myself for sticking with it. But in reality, I just feel like this is it's a new beginning. It's like, okay, we get to set a new goal, which is super exciting. It's the same idea that's sort of explored in Simon Sinek's book called The Infinite Game. And it's this idea where some games we play to win, like football or soccer or baseball, there's set rules, there's expectations, there's an end. There's an end with a clear-cut winner and loser. But some games we try to play in perpetuity, meaning we play them with no end in mind because, well, the point of the game is to try and perpetuate the game for as long as possible. And well, I guess that's sort of how I feel about this milestone, is that it's not the end all of be all. It's like just another milestone that's now behind me. And now I get to make new goals and I get to set new expectations and I get to strive for bigger and greater things and I get to keep going. And that's a really exciting feeling. Up until now, I've primarily used this channel to try and educate and inspire people through storytelling and more practical hands-on videos discussing, you know, self-developed strategies that I've used that have helped me get through the most tumultuous periods throughout this process of becoming a doctor. And I think that will always be a part of the channel, and I don't want that part to go away. Going forward, thinking larger, I want to try and use this channel to help advocate for different perspectives in public health. I want to use the platform that I'm trying to create to illuminate stories and about what I see are shortcomings of medicine and education, and how we might use the information, the research that we have at our disposal, so that we can make more informed, better decisions about our health, about decisions in medicine. And you know, not that this channel has made any sort of money whatsoever, but I would like to think that one day, if the channel ever does become prominent enough, I can use things like ad revenue, sponsorships and promotions and donations that help to fund projects that directly contribute to increasing the availability of open access resources for causes that I believe in. Because while I love vlogging and I love, you know, talking about these more hands-on, practical, educational type videos, I also want to have a deeper impact on the public health community, on the medical community. And so that's where I see the direction of this channel heading. And so I have no idea if any of that will happen, but those are the principles in which I sort of want to base the future of this channel upon. And I promise to always double down on the quality of my videos, to invest in this channel, to invest in you guys, to create the high quality content that you find is both useful and entertaining. If you did get this far in the video, hit me up with a comment and ask me a question. It can be a question about literally anything. If I get enough, I promise to answer it in an upcoming Q&A video. And if you know of somebody out there who might find this YouTube channel fun, beneficial, entertaining, educational, or helpful in any capacity, send them our way. Let them join the squad. It'd be fun. I guess that's it, guys. Again, I don't have much else to say other than just like a big, big thank you. I am so grateful for each and every one of you who have reached out and have expressed how my videos have in some way impacted your life in a very meaningful and positive way. And again, that's just what motivates me to keep doing this. I'm incredibly happy and excited for the future of this channel. And I hope that I continue making videos for a long time to come. So without further ado, guys, I'll let you go. And as always, we will see you in the next video. Peace out.